this, it's this one, right? This is
what it's open to the you look to the ribbons.
Okay, yeah, so I'm looking like, are we doing a different one? Okay.
No, it's the ribbons.
Okay, are you going to do half of the gospel? So you want me to take this one?
Yeah.
Yes, the Acts of the Apostles. Do you want me to?
Yeah, just put it down.
Okay. Do we have an organist? Okay.
So we're going to say the normal. So you'll
right,
do the,
like I do in the morning at the morning mass. How about the Missalette, the entrance antiphon?
She's going to sing. We're going to have a cappella singing, but not before the mass parts.
Oh, okay. So I just have to say turn the page.
Nope.
Oh, not. Don't even mention the entrance antiphon.
She's singing.
Oh.
A cappella means singing without music, without the organ.
Oh, all right.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, so she's singing.
Okay, but I still have to do the responsorial.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're not. She's singing, but she's not singing the mass parts.
Okay. All right. Cool.
We hear the closing hymn and some other hymns.
Okay. Thank you.
Thanks. But yeah, this is very powerful, Nils.
Okay. All right. Sounds good to me.
Good morning, everyone. For our entrance procession, please join in singing Christ the Lord is Risen Today, number 178. 178.
Good morning. Praise be the name of Jesus. Our second collection this weekend is for parish special needs. This Mass is being offered for the living and deceased members of the Holy Rosary Society. Together, let us recite the prayer to Saint Michael. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
As you know, we've had Easter, right? Easter was a few weeks ago.
Since then, we've had about 8 funerals here at the parish.
And every one of the funerals has given us a flower. So I call these the resurrection flowers. They all came back, and they're all here from all different funerals the last 2 weeks. But as we begin today,
we ask the Lord to watch over us, to bless us, to keep us safe, happy, holy, and healthy as we celebrate the resurrection. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit, gathering this day as God's family, let us acknowledge our sin. Let us so prepare ourselves to celebrate these, the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit,
in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. May your people exalt forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now at the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the Holy and Righteous One and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are all witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, let your face shine on us. Lord, let your face shine on us. When I call, answer me, O my just God. You who relieve me when I am in distress, have pity on me and hear my prayer. Lord, let your face shine on us. Know that the Lord does wonders for his faithful one. The Lord will hear me when I call upon him. Lord, let your face shine on us. O Lord, let the light of your countenance shine upon us. You put gladness into my heart. Lord, let your face shine on us. As soon as I lie down, I fall peacefully asleep. For you alone, O Lord, bring security to my dwelling. Lord, let your face shine on us. A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the Righteous One. He is expiation for our sins, and not only for us, but not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, "I know him," but do not keep his commandments, are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God, is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. Lord Jesus, open the scriptures to us. Make our hearts burn while you speak to us. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified, and they thought that they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have the flesh and bones as you can see I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" He gave them a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and the repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
During the season of Lent, much of the focus on our liturgy is on sin and forgiveness. We hear about many ways that people reject God and how they sin. We read about the effects of sin on mankind. We witness Jesus suffering the effects of our sins. But now at Easter time, as we celebrate the new life of the Lord, maybe surprisingly, but we come upon a Sunday when all three readings reflect on sin. Peter, in the Acts of the Apostles, tells the leaders of the Jews that Jesus' death and resurrection had been predicted by the prophets, that they should now turn towards God. Their sins will be wiped away. In the second reading, John says that Jesus is our offering for sin, ours and everybody's. And Luke in the Gospel gives the account of the first meeting of the resurrected Lord with the 11, concluding with the mandate, "In the name of Jesus, penance for the remission of sins is to be preached to all nations." The reflection on sin and on penance, though, differs today from that of Lent. The focus on Easter is not on the evils of sin, but on redemption from sin. With the resurrection of Christ, the world, you and I, we've been transformed. We're no longer mired by evil. The world is being restored to God's original plan. He has given us life. He has conquered sin, which is death, so we may be united in his resurrected life. Now, there are many people in our world who don't know this yet. There are people in the world who have heard about Christ. Maybe they've heard about religion, about forgiveness, but they haven't been led to that experience of the Lord's forgiveness. These people may be people of the deep, dark night, suffering in a world of prostitution, sex industry, the drug culture. They're exploited by others to become rich. They see their only option in life being to make the best of their situation or to end their lives. Now, these people, they haven't witnessed the transformation of life. No one has brought them the witness of the resurrection. Maybe the people in darkness are the people of lonely homes or lonely lives. They've worked long and hard, getting most out of the world that they could. Their lives, their homes, they're full of beautiful things. Now that their dreams have been fulfilled, they realize they're not happy, that they need more in life. But there's nothing left for them to buy. No one has brought them the witness of the resurrection. Perhaps the people who haven't witnessed the new life of Jesus are those who move from one experience, one new experience, to another. Commitment is an antiquated notion, whether it's commitment to other people, to a cause, or even to their own well-being. Their lives are continually in flux. It's like a marathon, but one without a finish line. They keep running and running, mainly running away from themselves. They need someone to give witness to a new way of life. the way of the Lord. I am not a ghost, says the Lord in the gospel. I am real. The resurrection is real. There's a new and better way to live. And he says, go tell the world. You are my witnesses. Well, my friends, you and I are his witnesses to a new and better life, a life of Christ. I want to tell you about a wonderful lady that I once knew when I was in South Philly. Her name was Rosa Musso. She was 90 years old, resident of a nursing home in South Philly. One Easter Sunday, she learned about the death of one of her sons. Now, she came to Mass the Thursday after Easter. She asked me if I would visit her at the home as soon as possible. So I made it a point to go the next day. Do you know what she wanted to tell me? This 90-year-old lady, confined to a wheelchair, was she grieving over her own son's death? Now, she wanted me to know that there was a lady across the hall from her in a nursing home who didn't have God in her life. She said to me, Father, how could she live like that? I talked to her. You need to talk to her. Now, Rosa, she was a witness to the resurrection. She was not a theologian, but she understood that life without the Lord is different. It's transformed with the Lord. Life without him is different. It's meaningless. When confronted with someone living a meaningless life, as a Christian, she had to do something about it. She had to give witness to God in our world, give witness to God in her life. Now, very few of us are called to deeds of heroic courage in our faith. We're not asked, as some of the saints, like St. Ignatius was, to choose between renouncing the faith or being thrown to wild animals in the Colosseum. But you and I were called to be witnesses of the faith. Now, there are so many people in our world, even in our own families, whose lives are meaningless because no one has given them witness to the new and better and transformed life of the Lord. So they depend on us. They depend on us to give this witness, not just as a concept of the church, or not just from the priest, but as much as each individual, each one of us, reflecting on that new life of the Lord in our own lives. Now, there are people in our world who will accept your witness to Jesus Christ because they've come to know you and respect you. You need to lead them to God. They need you to lead them from a meaningless life. They need you to be a witness to freedom from darkness and sin, a witness to a new life, a witness to the resurrection. The president of Life Teen, Randy Reyes, writes about a story of his conversion. He hadn't been raised in any faith, but in high school he was attracted to a beautiful girl who he found out was a Catholic, and she was deeply involved in her parish. Now, he used this as an opportunity to talk to her. He asked her, hey, can I join you at Mass? She said, sure. Randy felt that this was just a small step from dating her. So he went to Mass with her. After Mass, they went for ice cream. She asked him, so what did you think about the Mass? He didn't have a clue. He was only paying attention to her. But he said, it was wonderful. So then she asked, what part of the homily did you like? He babbled on. She asked, did you pay attention to the readings? Do you even remember what the readings were? He babbled a lot more. He figured, well, she's not going to ever want to see me again. Instead, she said, if you'd like to come with me again next week, fine. But this time, try. Well, he did go with her the next week, and he did try. Little by little, he fell in love with the Lord, fell in love with the Catholic faith. Eventually, he became a Catholic. He went on to be part of the founding of the Life Teen organization. And that girl, did he marry her? No. She didn't become his wife. But she was a witness to the resurrection. I pray that you and I will fulfill the mission that Christ gave us when he called us to tell the world he lives.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, let us stand, and together let us recite our creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man.
Hands out of
here. Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We pray that all of us may be drawn more intimately into God's love and mercy. We offer our prayers today for our needs, the needs of the world around us.
For God's holy church, that we may hear the same call as the disciples in today's gospel, being witnesses to Christ's resurrection in the world. We pray to the Lord. For international cooperation in being good stewards of our environment and sharing the Earth's resources. We pray to the Lord. For those who are struggling in their lives, for those battling mental illness, depression, or addictions, may they feel God encouraging them on their journey. We pray to the Lord. For all who thirst for justice and an end to violence, hatred, and prejudice in our cities, our neighborhoods, our country, and throughout the world, we pray to the Lord. For healing for the sick and the shut-in, for the repose of the souls of the faithful departed, and for the living and deceased members of the Holy Rosary Society, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Kindle our own generosity so that we may share the blessings you bestow upon us through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our risen Lord, forever and ever.
Please join in singing number 207, Holy, 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 number 207.
Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, early in the morning our song shall rise to thee. Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, God in three persons. Assisi, cherubim and seraphim, falling down before thee, which was and art and evermore shall be.
My sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. For the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all his holy church. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church. And as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life. The halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. Even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father, most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, he led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and we have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life, and the chalice a blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ has been handed on to us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all peoples may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with St. John Cantius, our patron saints, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed now by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other now a sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Lamb of God,
you take away
the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
And for our Holy Communion hymn, please join in singing number 179, At the Lamb's High Feast, 179.
At the Lamb's High Feast we sing, praise to our victorious King. He has washed us in the tide, flowing from his open side. Praise we him whose love divine gives his sacred blood for mine, gives his blood for the feast. Christ the victim, Christ the priest. Where the paschal blood is poured, death's dark angel shield is sore. Israel's triumphant go through the way that drowns the foe. Praise we Christ whose blood was shed, paschal victim, paschal bread, with sincerity and love, eat we manna from above. Easter triumph, Easter joy, sin alone can this destroy. From sin's power do thou set free, souls newborn, O Lord, in thee. Hymns of glory, songs of praise, Father, unto thee we raise. Risen Lord, all praise to thee, with the Spirit ever be. At the Lamb's High Feast we sing, praise to our victorious King. He has washed us in the tide, flowing from his open side. Praise we him whose love divine gives his sacred blood for wine, gives his body for the feast. Christ the victim, Christ the priest.
Moistened foot through the Red Sea.
waters.
A few announcements this morning. One big announcement is that today is our parish bingo. It starts at 2 p.m. Doors open at 1 p.m. Tickets are available back in the back of the church, or you can buy your tickets at the door today. And our Holy Rosary Society is here. I invite them to now stand for our prayer to the Lady of the Rosary. Blessed Mother Mary, we turn to you in prayer for all the people in these United States. We place ourselves in your care, in the gentle hands that cradled the child Jesus. We ask you to make us more alive in our faith, more generous in your love, more trusting in your hope. Teach us to imitate Jesus as you did. Make us a people of compassion, generosity, and peace. Free us from all selfishness and self-interest, that we truly might be the children of God and the builders of his kingdom. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who turn with confidence to you today. Amen. And naturally, our Holy Rosary Society is always looking for new members. They meet occasionally, at least once a month. They're over in the chapel with the Blessed Sacrament, and they have a general meeting with food, so you can always come for some food. But they're here, and they're a good part of our parish community. So I thank them for being here today and for all that you do for us. Let us stand and pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads for God's blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessings.
Amen. Amen.
May he, by whose redeeming word you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen. Amen.
And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen. Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you all, remaining with you forever.
Amen.
Our masses end. Let us go forth in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed day.
Please join in our Regina Caeli prayer, which is on number 186, 186.
Regina Caeli, let our prayer, alleluia, qui nomen Christi portare, alleluia, resurrexi, sicut dixit, alleluia.
And please join in our recessional hymn, The Day of Resurrection, number 177. 177.
The day of resurrection has spread the news abroad. The Paschal Feast of Gladness, the Paschal Feast of God. From death to life eternal, from earth to heaven's height, our Savior Christ has brought us the glorious Lord of light. Our hearts be free from evil, that we may see aright. The Savior resurrected
in his eternal light. And hear his message plainly, delivered calm and clear. Rejoice with me in triumph, be glad and do not fear.
That's fine. Anywhere up here.
Okay. Thank you.